Welcome to the tutorial Visualization Project with EasySoft 8 for EasyE RTD Advanced. This video shows an exemplary visualization project with the EasyE Remote Touch Display Advanced, which was created with EasySoft 8. The content of this video includes the startup wizard of the EasyE RTD, the presentation of the example project with EasySoft 8, the functions of the screens created with EasyE RTD, the transfer of the created project of the EasyE RTD and the EasyE 4, the device menu of the EasyE RTD. The following technical requirements must be met. A full color display EasyE Remote Touch Display Advanced EASY RTD DC 4303B200 with over 65,000 possible colors for the display of text, values, parameters or graphics. An EASY E4 basic device with firmware version greater than or equal to 2.10, EASYSoft programming software version greater than or equal to 8.10. A license is required for the EASYSoft programming software. Software, firmware and updates can be downloaded at www.eaton.com/software. Some notes. The setup of the EasyE RTD is supported by a setup wizard. The remote touch display currently offers menu navigation in 13 different languages. It is possible to define access for specific user groups, watcher, operator and administrator. In addition, password-protected access for all three user groups prevents access by third parties. In addition to the visualization, the display of the EasyE 4 can also be mirrored as with the EasyE RTD standard. In the maximum configuration, up to 8 EasyE 4s could communicate with up to 4 EasyE RTD Advanced. A maximum of 255 screens with a maximum of 255 elements per screen can be created. In the exemplary setup, the devices are arranged as follows. The EasyE RTD Advanced and the EasyE 4 basic device are connected to the PC via an Eaton Ethernet switch XN3325ETH-UMS. Fixed IP addresses in the range 192.168.119 are used for the setup shown. The EasyE RTD Advanced has the end address 51, the EasyE 4 the end address 60, and the PC in this case the end address 10. After booting a factory set EasyE RTD, the setup wizard starts automatically and asks for the desired language. If not already available, the connection to a network for an EasyE 4 can be made at this point. The next step in this tutorial is to import a prepared visualization project via the USB interface. To do this, the USB interface must be enabled and the import confirmed with yes. The desired configuration file of the visualization project can now be imported via the selection. The project was imported at this point without a connected EasyE 4, which is why no connection is established in the next step. The network settings assigned in the project appear. If no visualization project is imported, the passwords for the three user groups Watcher, Operator and Administrator are defined below and must be repeated for each acceptance. In addition, the start behavior of the EasyE RTD is defined and the necessary settings for integrating the EasyE RTD into a network are made. For the EasyE 4 UC12RC1 used in this project, the following settings were made for communication. In the Ethernet tab, the static IP address setting was selected. The IP address of the EasyE 4 was then set to 192.168.119.60 and the subnet mask to 255.255.255.0. In addition, the checkboxes enable configuration via network and, very important, under EZE RTD Advanced, allow visualization were set. This project also includes an EZCOM SWDC1 communication module with several connected devices, where in this case only the contactor C1.1, the indicator light C1.4 and the potentiometer C1.5 are used for the simulation. Finally, the EZE RTD Advanced Visualization Device was added. In the System Settings tab, the automatic logout and the start behavior of the EZE RTD were defined. In this project, the visualization should be started automatically, as previously configured. The user groups for operating the device menu are handled in the same menu. This definition is separate from the handling of the user groups for selecting the screens in the EZE RTD. The static IP address setting was selected in the Ethernet tab. The previously assigned data from the EZE RTD setup wizard for the IP address and subnet mask were adopted here. Select the visualization view to access the screen overview and the screen editor. The screen overview shows the screens prepared here. One of the three screens has been defined as the start screen. Password protection can be set here for each screen. In this case, the start page screen has no password protection. If, for example, you want to prevent the visualization from being exited, this page could also be password protected. The names assigned to users 1 to 3 can be found in the Passwords tab. In the following tabs, a language selection or a screen activation, for example for a fault screen, can be made via EZE4. Double-click on screen 1 to open it. Three static bitmaps have been inserted in the middle. As shown here at the top left, it is very important to create a universal button with a Switch to device menu button function. Otherwise, there is no way to exit the visualization. At the bottom left is the universal button with the login logout button function for logging in the various user groups. If no user is logged in, only the buttons for switching screens and exiting the visualization are active. On the right hand side, the two other screens are pre-selected using universal buttons. Bitmaps have been placed on the buttons here. To position the individual buttons, the reference button is selected first, and then the other desired button or buttons are included in the selection by activating the control key. The symbols shown above can now be used to align the button to the respective outer frame and the dimensions of the button. The second screen is selected via the screen overview. The universal button at the bottom left has been used to switch to the start page. The button has been assigned a house symbol as a bitmap. At the bottom right is the screen changed to the third screen. The symbol was copied from the start page and aligned accordingly. A value entry input element was positioned on the left for the setpoint specification. The value range was configured to 20 to 100 with the unit of measure percentage and assigned to the marker word 257. This value was selected to avoid unwanted overlaps with marker bits or marker bytes. A transparent universal button with the changeover relay button function was created as the on-off button. The visibility of the respective possible switching function takes place via the control via marker 1. If marker 1 is true, The red button becomes visible and the drive can be switched off. If marker 1 is false, the green button is visible and the drive can be switched on. All three elements are arranged one above the other. The information at the bottom right is helpful for positioning and dimensions. Finally, a static text is inserted on the left-hand side. To the right of the input element for entering values is the value display element, which is also controlled in terms of visibility via marker 1. The visibility of the respective possible switching function is controlled via marker 1. A counter, controlled by a flashing relay with 10 Hz, was used in the program for the simulation, which counts up or down via comparator depending on the counter output for the specified value. The load of the drive is displayed here with a color change from green to orange at 80% and flashing red at 90%. Below this, also controlled via marker 1, is the image of the pump activated as an example in this case. The universal buttons for switching screens are again located on the left-hand side of the last screen. In this case, the example fan for temperature control is switched on and off using a latching button via marker 2. The color changes for the status change were defined as red and green. The symbolic fan is represented by two overlapping bitmaps. The second bitmap for the simulation of the rotating fan only contains the fan blade wheel, which is controlled at 1 Hz via marker 6 using a flashing relay. The flashing relay is enabled via Q17 when the fan is started. In addition, the symbol for an air outlet, controlled via Q17, is visible at the output of the ventilation duct. The simulated temperature display via potentiometer, analog input 09 on marker word 261, is located on the right-hand side. A bar graph with color change was positioned there when threshold values of the marker word 261 used are reached. The optimum temperature range between 20 and 50 degrees Celsius has been defined here as an example. Outside this range, the selected colors flash blue and red. The current value of the marker word 261 is displayed below the bar graph. The bar graph and value display are located below or on a bitmap for the thermometer. The various mask elements of the temperature display can be arranged using the toolbar. A plausibility check is carried out to check the project. By selecting the communication view, the visualization project and the EZE4 program can now be transferred. Transfer the EZE RTD project, the assigned administrator password must be entered. If the EZE RTD is in run status, you will be asked whether the EZE RTD can be set to stop status. After a successful download, you will be asked whether the EZE RTD should be set to run status again. To download the EZE4 project, communication with the EZE RTD is terminated and a connection to the EZE4 is established. If the certificate error message appears during the download, the correct time and date are missing in the EZE4. In this case, the download is started anyway. A further security message appears stating that no password has been assigned for the project. No password is used in this video tutorial. If the EZE4 is in run status, a security prompt appears asking whether the EZE4 should be set to stop status as with the EZE RTD. As the correct date and time have still not been set, the certificate error message is displayed again. Again, the connection to the EZE4 is established anyway. After the successful download, you are asked whether the EZE4 should be set to run status again. As an alternative to downloading the project directly to the respective device, the configuration file can also be saved on a USB stick for the EZE RTD or on a micro SD card for the EZE4. This is followed by a brief demonstration of how to change users in EZE RTD. On the start page, a supervisor is logged in who has access to all screens and can operate all elements of the respective screen. If only the visitor is logged in, he can view some of the screens but cannot trigger any action. Use the universal button at the top left to switch to device menu. All selection options in the device menu are only visible after logging in here as administrator. This video tutorial does not claim to have shown all the possibilities of the EZE RTD Advance, such as explaining all the available display and input elements in terms of usability and visibility. An initial overview of the possibilities of EZE RTD has been provided here. Thank you for your attention.